Now let us begin to develop a level 3 schedule in Primavera. We have taken all the input that what are the activities in the project, what is the scope, what will be the duration, and now we need to develop it into the Primavera. So we have also defined the project. Now we are defining the WBS. So to create a WBS, we'll go to the WBS window and we will add a new WBS. So to systematically manage the program, we have divided the project into civil work, finishing work, MEP work, and further categorize civil work into substructure and superstructure. This will help us to define a large number of activities and manage it in an effective and efficient way. So first, we have defined the civil work as a WBS, under which we will provide two further heads: substructure, in which we will define all the activities which is to be carried out in the substructure, and then superstructure, in which we will define all the activities which will be carried out in a superstructure. Right now the WBS code is set as a default. However, this code can be utilized later on for filtering, sorting and grouping. For sake of simplicity, we are keeping it as same. Now the last WBS is finishing, which has been defined. Now once finishing and MEP. So once we define all the WBS, the major work packages, then the next step would be to define the activities. Now the first activity is site handover for construction, and its WBS is the project itself. So we'll select the project and we'll click on the add sign to define the new activity. So what all information we need to provide? First, we need to provide the activity name. For the simplicity, we will put activity code as 0. So in this way, we have defined the activity name. The next is the WBS which it has already taken. Then the activity type, it's a start milestone. So we have chosen the activity type as start milestone. The other details we will not define as of now, and we will take it further in the coming sessions. So we have defined the very basic details about the activity, which is site handover for construction. The next thing is the cleaning activity. So we will select the relevant WBS substructure. We'll take the code as 10 and activity name as cleaning. Now WBS has been already selected. By default, Primavera will take task dependent as a type of activity. All other information we will feed later on in the system. So as of now, we do not require to add all these details. So we need to add only 3 details: activity ID, its name, and the activity type. The WBS we are directly selecting from the screen. So again, one more activity under substructure after cleaning will be the marking. The duration is also we are putting directly on the screen. So automatically it will take the ID with the increment of 10. So 10 plus 10 is 20. We have defined the activity as marking. All other information will be as it is. So this details of relationship we will define once we define all the activities or all the scope. Now after the marking, the next thing is the excavation. Now the excavation is a 12 day duration activity. So we will define a new activity by clicking on the add activity symbol and rename it as excavation. The ID is automatically taken by the Primavera with an increment of 10. WBS have been selected by us, by default task dependent, and other details as of now it's not required. Now here you see again and again we are getting a details which are not required to be filled by us, making the entire process lengthier for us. Now we want to shorten this process and we want to feed the data in a Primavera in a faster way. For doing this, there is an option you can untick this do not show the wizard. Once you click on do not show the wizard, it will not be visible. You can directly enter the data. But if you require, see, by adding the activity directly, the activity is added and you have to feed the data on the main screen. but in the beginner process, you need this wizard to guide you. So you can go to user preference, assistance, and again tick mark on the activity wizard. So once you tick mark it, again it will guide you to put the activity step by step with the required details. Now once you add few activities and gain the expertise in adding the details of the activity, you can again untick this activity wizard option to expedite the entire process of making the schedule. But once you untick the activity wizard option, then you need to add the relevant column. So you need to go to the column and you need to add all those columns in which you need to feed the details. For example, we need to feed activity ID. So I am adding activity ID as the first column. Once the activity ID is added, the next column is activity name. The next activity detail we required is the duration. We also required the calendar, the activity type, though the WBS is represented by the color coding. So to add the calendar, again we go to the column and we will select the calendar from the list. Now in general, you can go and select the calendar and use the arrow command to arrange it that where you want to locate it on the main table and the activity type. So we have added calendar and activity type, but before the start date, we also need the original duration so that we can feed the duration of the activity. So we will add original duration as a column between the activity name and start date. Now once we make this required changes with the user interface, we will not be requiring the wizard to enter the activity detail. And now we can start entering the data in more faster way. So after excavation, we can have a PCC, which is a 6-day duration. We can change directly on the screen by clicking on the cell showing the duration. The next activity after PCC is footing. We can rename the activity on the main screen and change its duration from 4 days to 12 days. The next activity after footing will be the backfilling, and its duration is 4 days, so it will be kept as it is. So Primavera take 4 days as a default duration for the activity. The next activity is a plinth beam that can be added with the duration of 12 days. Now if you want to add more activities, you can add, click on the symbol of add activity. So the next activity is the great slab. The activity ID is taken by the Primavera with the increment of 10. The duration of great slab is again 4 days. So in this way, substructure has been defined by us. Now moving to superstructure, now suppose there are 5 activities. So I can click on the symbol 5 times and add those activities. Here again, we can change the activity code, its name, and then the duration for each of the activity. Now once we define all the activity in the superstructure, we can change the duration. Now there is a question whether the WBS can be changed later on. For example, we want blockwork in the finishing WBS. Then what is to be done? Then you can select the blockwork, go to general of activity detail and select or change the WBS. So yes, in Primavera it is possible to change the WBS in the later on stage. So we have changed the WBS of blockwork from superstructure to finishing work. Now adding the activity in finishing work, but before that, let us first change the duration of the superstructure. So slab, let us take, it will take 14 days minimum or 12 days minimum. Let us take column that it will take 6 days to complete, and the deshuttering and destaging will take minimum 3 days to complete. Now adding the activities in the finishing WBS, in a similar way we can add all the activities in finishing work. So first will be the block work which has been added. The second one is the plaster. The plaster activity is renamed The next activity to plaster is painting. Although at site, after plaster, the electrical or MEP work will happen. But since it's in a work package, we are trying our best to put activity in a sequence, although it is not mandatory. So after plaster at site, MEP work will happen and then painting will happen. But here in a work package, we are putting painting after the plaster. Now finishing completion and site handover to client. Now finishing completion is an activity which is not a task dependent. It's a finishing milestone. It's a WBS summary. So we want finishing milestone as a WBS summary. So we can change its activity type from task dependent to WBS summary by clicking on the main screen. So now it will show the duration of the finishing WBS. And site handover to client, it will be a finishing milestone. Now we must remember, to finishing milestone or starting milestone, we have to put the relationship. And for the WBS summary, we do not have to put relationship. And for start and finishing milestone, the activity duration will be zero. Now these are few important information that you must have. Now similarly, we will put the details in the MEP work. So first we are putting the activity code so that we can filter it later on. Although we have kept it a simple numerical for simplicity. In real project, we can use M word in the activity code so that all activities starting with M can relate to the activity of MEP. So first is the mechanical work we define, then we define the electrical work, and then we define the plumbing work. And we need one more activity which shows the summary of the MEP work WBS, which is MEP work completion. Now mechanical work is of 4-day duration, so we are keeping it as it is. Electrical work is of 7-day duration, so we are changing the duration to 7 days. Plumbing work is of 3-day duration, so its duration has been changed to 3 days. And MEP work completion, we do not require to put duration, we can change it to WBS summary and duration will be calculated by the Primavera. Now this is the first step of defining the activity in the Primavera. Next, we need to change the calendar of each activity selected here. So here we have changed the calendar to Global Sample Project Calendar. Similarly, for all other activities, the required calendar can be changed. The calendar plays a very important role because it decides the timeline of the activity based on duration on the calendar or the Gantt chart. So if the activity is of 3 days, but there is a Sunday, Saturday off in between, so it will be reflected 5 days. So the calendar can change the entire schedule, and hence it becomes very important that we define a right calendar in a Primavera. Now we will also define the calendar for the MEP work. Its time is different. It has a Saturday off. So that need to be provided to the Primavera so it calculates the duration accordingly. Now once we assign the calendar to each of the activity as per the working hour defined by the organization, so we created the calendar and assigned to each activity. The next step will be to define the relationship. Now to define the relationship, you can go to activity detail and then predecessor. Click on the assign and select the predecessor. So for excavation, the predecessor is marking. There is another way, is that you can add a column predecessor. So click and add predecessor as a column on the main screen. Once you add the predecessor, click on the OK. Now here we have the predecessor. Now you can directly click on the activity predecessor and select its predecessor. For PCC, the predecessor will be excavation. For footing, can only start after PCC. The backfilling can only happen after footing. The plinth beam predecessor is backfilling. The grade slab predecessor is plinth beam. For slab, the predecessor will be the grade slab. For column, the predecessor will be the grade slab. For deshuttering and destaging, the predecessor will be the slab. For block work, the predecessor will be the deshuttering and destaging. For painting, to start the painting work, the predecessor will be plaster as well as the mechanical job. Now for mechanical work, the predecessor will be the plaster. After completion of plaster, we are considering that mechanical work will start. So we will select the mechanical work and assign the plaster as a predecessor for mechanical work, for electrical work, and for the plumbing work. Now for MEP work completion, it's a WBS summary, hence does not require a relationship. Now finishing completion, the predecessor is not required, it's a WBS summary. And for site handover to client, which is a finishing milestone, hence required a predecessor, which is a painting. So for site handover to client, will can only happen after the painting. Now once we define the predecessor, we need to recheck the logic, because relationship is the prime tool in the Primavera which define the correctness of the schedule. So after relationship, we need to check the logic that whether it, what kind of relation it will have with the predecessor. For example, marking will have a start to start relation with the predecessor. Once the cleaning is started, the marking can also be started. So we can check this relationship type by using the Gantt chart. It can easily show us the correctness by the visibility in the graphical form. So you can select the data date as the current date, which is 1st Jan 2021 on which the schedule is being prepared. Now here you can see the cleaning activity once started, next day the marking can be started. Now once the marking is completed, we want to start the excavation, but we want to start excavation with the start of the marking. So putting the relationship type as start to start. But since practically it cannot happen on the same day, we will put a site local condition through lag. So we'll put 2-day lag. So once we put 2-day lag, we are saying that after the start of marking, we will take 2 days to start the excavation. Now the relationship is the prime constant which cannot be changed. It will be same on any of the construction site. But when we talk about the lag, then it entirely depend upon the local condition of the construction project. For example, in this we can consider that as per the front, next after 2 days of the marking, the excavation can be started. So we have put the relationship accordingly. Now after the excavation, we want to ensure that PCC gets complete next day of excavation, putting the relationship as finish to finish, so that PCC does not get delayed, and putting the lag as 1 day. Now here you can see after completion of excavation, the PCC getting completed next day. Now after PCC, the next activity is footing. But before that, we can also manage the Gantt chart. Right now we want only non-critical activity in green and critical activity in red. So we are untick all other options and will tick only the green tab and the red tab for critical and non-critical work. So for footing, let us see, after PCC we want footing to start immediately, so we'll put start to start relation with a lag of 1 day. So next day of PCC we want footing to complete, so next day of PCC the footing must start. Now after completion of footing, we want backfilling to finish within 2 days, so it must have finish to finish relation. So once the footing is complete, within next 2 days we want the backfilling to be completed. Now once the backfilling is completed, only after 100% completion of backfilling we can start the plinth beam, because in backfill we will be using machinery. So considering the local site condition and the area of the project, we cannot do the backfill and the plinth beam together, and hence we are keeping the relationship as finish to start. And when the plinth beam work is ongoing, considering the small area of the project, we will start the grade slab only after completion of the plinth beam. And once the grade slab will complete in single go, we will start the slab again, finish to start relation. Now after grade slab, we can also start the column having a finish to start relation. But column has one more dependency. A column must complete to complete the slab. So we can have one more relation in the slab. Column can act as a predecessor to slab with its relation finish to finish. So we can change the relation as finish to finish. So in slab, the predecessor column will have finish to finish, or if we put start to start, it will show as critical. We are saying that it must start with the slab. Another thing, what we are saying at site, it will be finish to finish. Before finish of the slab, the column must finish, which we will change later on. Now after slab, we will require 14 days to gain the strength, and then we can do the de-shuttering and de-staging. So we are putting 14 days lag. Only after completion of entire de-shuttering and de-staging, we can start the block work. So finish to start relation. After completion of block work, we can start the plaster. Now as a scheduler, you can consider to start it earlier. In Primavera, if we want to accelerate the work or accelerate the successor activity, we can use the negative of lag, which is lead. So if we put -3 and schedule it, the activity start will be accelerated. Though lead and lag is purely dependent upon the site condition, whether it's practically possible or not. Now after plaster activity, the MEP team can start the mechanical, electrical and the plumbing work. So the predecessor of mechanical, electrical and plumbing work is plaster. So selecting the predecessor of electrical work as plaster and for plumbing work as plaster. Now once the mechanical job, electrical job and plumbing job is completed, then the final painting can be done. So the predecessor to the painting activity will be the MEP completion. And moreover, the electrical work is of 7-day duration, and hence we can link the painting work with the electrical work. So the predecessor of painting can be assigned to electrical work. So once we assign the predecessor of painting, we will again reschedule it, and hence obtained painting in a critical path. Now only mechanical work, plumbing work is in green, making it non-critical. Now site handover. To complete the site handover, the predecessor will be the painting. So assigning activity ID 140 as a predecessor to site handover to client. Now since it's a milestone, it does not have a start date. Now all the relationship has been assigned. Now we have to consider the second part, which is the lag and lead, whether all the lag and lead is as per the site condition or not. So we can also see that to column, if we link it start to start to the slab, it will become critical, and if we link it finish to finish, the column will become non-critical and will have a float of 6 days. That means even if column is delayed by 6 days, the slab will not delay. And this is the case we are considering the site condition. Now let us see the logic behind the each activity. Marking is starting with the cleaning, and we have kept 1 day lag, which is practically possible at site. Then excavation is starting with marking, and we have kept 2 day lag. PCC is completing with excavation with 1 day lag. Then footing is starting with PCC with 1 day lag. footing and backfilling is finish to finish with 2-day lag, and plinth beam is finish to start to backfill. Grade slab will start after plinth beam, having a finish to start relation. The slab will start after completion of grade slab. The column will also start after completion of grade slab. After casting of slab, there is 14-day lags to gain the strength, and after that, deshuttering and staging is considered. The slab has two predecessors, one is the grade slab and one is the column. Column having finish to finish relationship. Now, after completion of deshuttering and destaging, only then block work can start. After completion of block work, we have considered the start of plaster by providing a negative lid, hence early starting the plaster. After plaster, we are starting the mechanical work, electrical work and plumbing work, logically that fit in the program. And after completion of MEP work, the painting work will start, and after completion of painting work, we are handing over the site. So relationship we have reviewed and all the relationship seems okay. Now the next thing we can check is the lag. Now finishing or handing over of site after completion of painting cannot happen the next day. Let us keep 15 days time to complete all the work to hand over the site. So once we do the painting, let us suppose we require minimum 15 days to hand over the site for all the other work. So if we schedule it after 15 days, our site handover date shifts. Now lag is to be provided considering the local site conditions. Now even in block work and plaster, if we consider a local site condition, we cannot start plaster until the block work is not completed because of the space constraint. So if we considering the same mason gang, or if we considering a space constraint, we are keeping the relation finish to start. Now our end date is coming up to 19th May. Now if we see the cleaning, we cannot start cleaning on the same day the site is handed over. We must require a mobilization time. So we are keeping 2-day lag to start the cleaning, and we are starting it by 4th January. And now if we see marking, we have kept 2-day lag. It can be done in 1 day. So all these changes can be made by the scheduler or maybe with the team after discussing the aspect to make it more practical. Once every stakeholder accepts the schedule, then it can be converted into a project document. So now we are making those changes which all the stakeholders agree. So if we take footing, the logic and schedule is okay. If we take backfilling, again the logic, the relationship and the lag is okay. However, we can reduce the lag by 1 day. So next day of footing, we can complete the backfilling. To reduce the project timeline, instead of 2 days lag, we are converting it to 1 day lag, which is practically possible for small building which we have taken up. Now if we see for plinth beam and grade slab, the logic is okay. So we can conclude that substructure will take 40 days, agreed by all the stakeholders. Now coming to superstructure, if we see there is no possibility to change the lead or lag or the relationship, so this is the best possible schedule. Again, we can fix it in 29 days. Now coming to finishing work, the block work is completing by 10th April. Again, all the relationship, logic and lag is again the best possible as per the current condition of the project. So 48 days can be considered, and for MEP work 7 days can be considered. So by this we have considered all the practical consideration through the feature of relationship and lag in Primavera, and the date, best possible date we can arrive is 20th May. So this is the schedule in which we have utilized the features of Primavera and implemented the scheduling techniques to prepare a feasible program which can give the direction to the management and to the project team for the execution of the work and the success of the project. However, it's still not completed because we haven't allocated the resources and the cost, which is the level 5 schedule. And in the coming session, we will attempt to develop a full-fledged level 5 schedule, which can be a single document to control the mega projects. Now, suppose we want to submit review the current project schedule, then we can go to file and we can take a print of it in the form of PDF, viewing all the details on the activity table and the Gantt chart. So once you save it as a PDF, our objective of preparing a level 3 schedule is completed, with the project start date 1st Jan 2021 and project end date 20 May 2021. If there is a specific client date, then we can use the lag command for the management buffer so that our relationship or the logic doesn't change. So we have come to the conclusion of preparing a level 3 schedule. Now let's move to level 5 schedule in the coming session.